Washington, Penny Nance. She's the CEO of Concerned Women for America. And I want to start just by going through the man's quoted here. And you wrote this to the Republican leadership. Social issues should be at the very top of the list of priorities for the new Congress, along with sensible fiscal policies. Americans voted overwhelmingly for both social and fiscal conservatives, and it would be unwise to throw social policies to the wayside and snub the voters who sent a strong message to the new Congress that they want both pro-life and fiscally conservative policies. It raises the question after this big Tea Party movement, but as the coalition grows, and the Democrats just went to campaigns were about spending, about the health care bill.
Proof's in the pudding. We got the vast majority of the people elected, the new people elected, are pro-life. And I would also say the Tea Party statistics are clear. 82% of them are pro-traditional marriage, 2/3 of them are pro-life. So we know who brung us to the dance. We know who elected this next Congress. It is social conservative and fiscal conservative. You know, incidentally, those issues go hand in glove. I mean, when you talk about big spending, that means $300 million a year for Planned Parenthood. That means all the extra money that go to pay for radical leftist ideas. We can cut spending and do social issues at the same time. We think Congress can chew gum and walk down the street at the same time.
Mr. Barron, look, Penny and her folks are the same ones who bragged about their access and influence the last failed Republican majorities. These are the same people who brought us Janet Jackson's nipple and gay marriage amendments and Terri Schiavo. And that's what we're talking about.
He says they'll be held accountable and punished if they do deal with the social issues. You're saying you'll hold them accountable and try to punish them
if they
don't.
That's ridiculous. The majority of the people who swept them in the office agree with the social conservative position. So, you know what? It's important that they do both, and I think they can. It's no problem. These issues go hand in glove. We can cut spending and go after public funding for abortion. There's no problem with that. There's no disconnect.
Christopher's simply
wrong on this. When social conservatives and fiscal conservatives unite, conservatives win.
That's right.
It happened in 80, it happened in 94, it even happened in 2000 with George W. Bush. Mm-hmm. History is you just can't argue with it. That's what happens. And what Chris wants to do is split this apart. And again, you split the social conservatives and fiscal conservatives. Guess what? The conservatives are back in the minority, and we have socialism running rampant like we do with this current Congress and current administration.
Look, we're not trying to split social conservatives off. Quite the contrary. What we're saying is going to be fought and won in our houses of worship, in our schools, in our community.
Conservatives are not trying to expand government. They're not trying to expand the size of government. Social conservatives are trying to do just the opposite.
And clearly, we have got to defend against an encroachment upon our families and our values. I'm sorry, you leave us no choice, which is why I ask you to publicly say that you will not push for a repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and domestic partner benefits, all those issues that the gay rights groups go after.
Penny, first off, again, I'm going to do whatever's in the... Our organization's going to do whatever's in the best interest of our United States military. That's great news. I assume that means you're not going to seek to amend the federal constitution to federalize marriage and family laws, something that had been the province of the states for 225 years, something that would be the largest single power grab by the federal government from the states in the history of this country. I hope you'll commit to ending that today.
We will clearly stand with the American people, the people even in liberal states like Maine who stand firm on traditional marriage. You're the encroacher, not us.
I'm going to the conversation as the Congress comes back into Washington.